It's hard to believe that Hurricane Ian was just 3 years ago. It dramatically impacted our coastline, damaging homes to coastal erosion.
The impact on coastal communities has become an experiment for Oregon State University. West 2's Gail Pascal Brown is live in studio tonight after talking to one of the professors involved in the research. Gail?
Yeah, the research involved graduate and undergraduate students as well as professors in the College of Engineering at Oregon State University. They focused on storm surge and how houses along coastal communities hold up with increasing waves.
God, my house is underwater.
Houses in Southwest Florida impacted by Hurricane Ian in 2022 prompted this experiment at Oregon State University just 2 weeks ago.
So those houses are 1 to 3, which means everything geometrically is 3 times smaller than a real house. But also the response of the house, how this house is broken and how it's damaged, is also scaled properly to represent what happens in nature.
It's all about seeing how houses in coastal communities hold up to storm surge. The experiment was conducted at the Hinsdale Wave Research Lab, where Pedro LaMonaco is director.
We build those in our directional wave basin. Our directional wave basin is, imagine, like an Olympic swimming pool, where we can generate waves.
The researchers replicated waves as close as possible to what you find in nature with increasing storm surges. The Salmon or Orange House was built to meet the 100-year flood standard, which is the current FEMA guideline. The Teal or Greenhouse was built to the 500-year standard and sits higher above the water. The wave strength was increased every 15 minutes until collapse.
What was the end result of this experiment?
The houses that are lower are going to be affected by waves sooner, and those are going to be damaged sooner. And the higher elevation houses are going to be more resilient and more resistant to those storm surge and those waves.
LaMonaco says they're still processing all the data. However, the information can be helpful in the future.
We have to accept that we have placed the houses in the wrong place. That's the first point. And we allow the construction of houses in places that were too risky, and now we are paying the price of that.
He says this may not be the most popular answer, but people may need to move their houses to places which are safer. He anticipates the experiment's results could be incorporated into building codes and where to locate your houses. Back to you.